I finally astral projected. I just wasn't aware that I was astral projecting. Holy fuck, dude, I'm so fucking excited.
Yeah, I'm about to expose every lie they done told, like how they trafficking kids and why they ain't got a soul. They feeding off my energy, trying to destroy the globe. They got weather control, they even making it snow. But we can't run from it, gotta grab it by the antlers.
I found this video very interesting, y'all. Astral projection, man. What is it, man? For those of you who don't know, astral projection is actually something that is done intentionally, okay? In order to project yourself into the astrals, you have to do it intentionally. Can it be done unintentionally? Yes, okay? But I do feel like this is a great video for beginners, okay? Me being one of those, okay? I'm a beginner myself in terms of actually trying to project myself into the astrals intentionally. I've only projected myself once, and that was actually unintentionally, okay? It was during a period of a time where I was asleep, a witch was riding my back. I refused to just, you know, let this happen. So I kind of tried to jerk myself out of it. And in the process, I jerked myself out of my body. Okay. But other than that, I've never actually been able to actually project myself intentionally. Okay. And I'm more so focused right now on doing it from a meditative standpoint. But, you know, I do feel like this video is good. You know, it's going to be some techniques in here that you're going to learn. That you're gonna love, you know, for a beginner who's actually trying to project themselves, okay? But with that being said, I wanna say that I cannot confirm or deny anything that's about to get ready to be said in this video, but I do ask that you guys use discernment when dealing with the information. And let's get into this, y'all.
This is going to be a very hard video to explain to anybody that knows me in real life. You're probably gonna think that I'm crazy, that I've literally lost my mind. I'm going to try to leave my body. I'm going to try to astral project. And the way that I do this is right before I sleep and right as I wake up, I keep holding onto my conscious mind so that I can stay awake mentally, but my body can fall asleep. And when my body falls asleep, I can literally just roll over and detach from my body and leave. I understand this sounds insane. I'm going to astral project and I'm going to tell you everything about it. It's going to be so cool. So I made a post on the astral projection subreddit looking for a AP mentor, someone to teach me exactly how to astral project over the course of a couple weeks. And people were actually pretty receptive. Like this guy said that I taught him a lot about lucid dreaming and he said good luck. People were really nice over here, and especially one person named Pawn Sacrifice sent me a DM, and this is the guy that taught me exactly how to astral project.
What I'm trying to help you with is to have either a spontaneous projection right when you fall asleep or transition into it upon waking up. When you're projecting, you're out of body. When you're dreaming, you're also out of body. They are siblings in the same family. You know that movie you keep on in the background just to have some noise and not pay attention to? That's the dream. Pausing in the middle of the movie? That's going lucid. Going to the movie selection menu? That's astral projection. Have you heard about WB2B, like wake back to bed? It's kind of like lucid dreaming, right? Because when you wake up, like about 5 hours in, you're disrupting that REM cycle, right? Because it gets shorter and shorter as you sleep. Before you go to sleep, I need you to write down affirmations. You need to do that clearly and precisely. But I think one of the keys is to be very specific with what you want. So there's different effects that you can experience while in the stage. You can get those vibrations, those kind of electric body sensations. You can have a sense of like a really rapid heartbeat, but it's not your heart. Don't be afraid. You might hear noises outside of your room. You might hear a roaring jet sound in your ears, but it's not hurting your ears. It's just really loud. So what you need to do when you start experiencing that stuff is you really need to stay calm. Number one, huge factor. Stay calm. It's fine. Nothing's going to happen to you. And so once you do that, it should subside. All those effects going to go away and it gets quieter. And that is when you do the next step, you exit. Transitional phase is passed, all those weird like vibrations or noises or anything have kind of quieted down. And that's when you try to get out.
I tried and I just...
I love that. I love the way he explained that, bro. He let him know what to expect during the transition of him actually exiting his body. He let him know the sounds that he was going to hear. He actually let him know how to actually astral project via positive affirmations. I love that. I feel like these are the things that we need to know, especially for beginners. You need to know not to be afraid when you hear certain sounds, and you know that you know it's easier for you to do it if you speak positive affirmations you know, before you go to sleep.
I don't know what it is, but lucid dreaming is so much more easy than this. trying to leave your body in that little 15 second transition stage of you being awake and you falling asleep is so much more complex. You have to have a lot of control over your mind.
I would have to repeat affirmations every single night, very similar to lucid dreaming, where I would tell myself, tonight I will astral project. I will astral project tonight. I am more than just my physical body. I would also visualize myself doing it. Before I would sleep, I would close my eyes and I would think about myself leaving my body. It's a very weird thing to think about, but I would visualize myself getting out of my physical body and walking around my room and leaving my bedroom and going to float around to other places. And just to go the extra mile, I would wake up every single night at 4 a.m, wake up, walk around, use the bathroom, and go back to bed in hopes of forcing myself back into a sleep state where I could then astral project.
I started feeling my body vibrating, like vibrating intensely, and it kept on like exponentially vibrating like higher and higher, like my entire body was like an Xbox controller. But I start to see my vision zoom out. Like, you see how in Call of Duty there's like a FOV slider, like field of view, how you can like zoom out of your current view and see more that's like around you. I started to hear this ringing noise in my ear, and it got really extremely like uncomfortably loud, but it didn't hurt my ears though. I got so excited that I actually heard that sound. He said to roll out way after the vibrations, way after the sounds, until it is back to a normal state. That's when you're in paralysis. And I moved out of my... I woke myself.
I wonder if that was a different... That was a him, you know, the frequency that he heard, the high-pitched sound. I wonder if that was him changing dimensions. So the frequency goes up because he's going into the, you know, into the astros. Yeah, I wonder if that's it.
I haven't slept right in the last 20-something days, and I would quit, but I remember exactly what it felt like to almost go astral. I know exactly what it feels like to be 90% there and almost get it.
Holy shit. Quick, let me tell you something before you go into the story. From me meditating and trying to go through, like when I meditate, I hold the thought of me actually traveling through the astros because I'm trying to go interplanetary, right? The farthest that I've ever gotten is to the point of why I start to feel my body begin to like almost sway, right? And then I see like this, I see like a tunnel. It's like I'm shooting fast through like through darkness. That's the farthest that I got. Man, y'all drop that in the comment section below and let me know if you've ever got to get full potential in terms of astral projection. And when you first start to astral project, what is it that you recognize first as you're going into the projection?
Your boy fucking astral projected after like, what, 40 days of setting alarms every single night and getting shitty sleep every single night. I finally astral projected. I just wasn't aware that I was astral projecting. Holy fuck, dude, I'm so fucking excited. I was laying down on my side and I turned over to tell my friends, yo guys, get out of my room. You guys are making so much noise and I'm trying to get some sleep. I'm trying to astral project. And my friends were just sitting there laughing. They're just jumping on the bed. They're playing Smash Bros. They had the TV blasted so loud. And I was like, yo, I can't get any sleep. Get out of my fucking room. And I didn't realize when I turned over, I left my body. I astral projected. I left my physical body.
So you basically did project and just need to get the hell up and out. Personally, I think there's some kind of automatic system sometimes to keep us from trying to experience it. For you, it was your friends making noise. Something was creating that to stop you. For me, I had the voice of my wife constantly talking to me during my experience, and I had to focus all the time to block it out. She wasn't even in the room when this was happening. Something was trying to distract me like it was doing to you. Stand up, clarity and awareness, and get the fuck out. The closer you are to your body, the easier it is to get pulled back in like a magnet.
I think today is like day 60 or 70, but I astral projected again. I woke up in the morning and then I said, oh wait, I should probably try to AP. So I lay back down and I just completely stay still while keeping my mind awake. I let my body fall asleep and I felt the weird tingly sensations throughout my entire body. I felt the like the vibration stage. And then right after that, I opened my eyes back up. I seen my mom come into my room and she was really, really loud. And she said, hey, Alex, make sure that you turn on the alarm. We're all leaving the house, okay? And then I was like, okay, mom. She kept on talking really, really loud. She kept on being persistent and loud and she was just doing a bunch of things to like wake me up. So I wake up and I was really, really pissed off. I was like, mom, I was literally almost astral projecting. She was like, what's that? And then when she said that, I was like, I told you what that was last week. Oh shit, that was an astral projection. That wasn't my real mom that walked into my room, told me to turn on the alarm. That's fucking intense, dude. Every time I astral project, something in the astral realm morphs into somebody that I know, like my friend, my cousin, my mother, and then they walk into my room and they make a lot of noises so that I think I'm waking up, but I'm actually astral. They try to distract me so I don't explore the astral realm. This has happened.
That sounds like a dream, though. It sounds more like a dream, if anything, like...
Twice so far. Damn, they got me again, bro. Fuck. And I walked around my house, right? I woke up and I went downstairs and I was like, damn it, man. I just got woken up. I was almost astral. I almost did it. And I was still astral. But I was so confused by whatever that thing was in the astral realm that looked like and talked like my mother. And I see my family there and I was just walking around and I got a cup of water. And then I eventually went back to my bedroom. And everybody was acting weird. Like... Everybody in my house was just like doing things that they don't normally do. Like, I don't know, like I saw like my dad home earlier than he normally is. It just, everything just felt a little bit off. See how when you first wake up and everything just looks blurry a little bit until you like blink your eyes like 5 times? So that's exactly what the astral realm looked like. When you just wake up, literally your eyes just wake up after like a 9-hour nap, and then everything is just blurry. I saw her walk through this door. She walked into my bedroom and she was really, really loud. It seemed like she was purposely trying to wake me up. There's something in another realm tricking me into coming back to this. That's so scary, dude.
If you can explain what happened to me, please comment that down below. I would love to understand the true explanation of what was happening to me twice in the astral realm. I am also dropping merch that says Thinking of God in Arabic.
I thought astral projection was like different. I thought that you could like go into the room, and that's the impression that I have of astral projection. And y'all let me know in the comment section below, but from my perception, astral projection is all about, well, when you actually go into the astrals, I should be able to come into your room and see you sleeping in your bed. I don't think it's more of a morphing thing. Okay. And someone who's actually astral projected would know probably more. But I do truly feel like that was more of a dream that he was in. It was more of a dream because he wanted the astral so bad that, you know, he dreamed about it. Because in dreams, like, you know, my sister can morph into my mother, or my girlfriend can morph into my mother. And that's more so of a symbolism. Not to say that we're not in the astrals then, but I feel like, you know, once you actually get into the astrals, from what I've heard, the many stories that I've heard, they've actually traveled far and beyond and actually visit people while they were in their homes eating food and things like that. All right, but y'all let me know in the comment section below if I'm wrong about that. All right, and with that being said, man, y'all make sure y'all get over to YouTube, follow me on YouTube at I Am Awaken. Right, also don't forget to follow me on Instagram at I Am Awaken _chosen one. And with that being said, man, I just want to leave y'all as I came. I want you guys to always be aware, because to be aware is to be alive. And as always, peace, family. Peace meaning positive energy. Always creates elevation. Ashay.